Hi students, welcome you all to the session. Today we will discuss about data handling in Python programming language. The different terms are data types, operators, mutable and immutable types, expressions, etc. We already learned about these all terms. Now we will discuss data handling in Python in detail. Let's start today's class. Data types. Data type in Python specifies the type of data we are going to store in any variable, the amount of memory it will take, and type of operation we can perform on a variable. You know about this, we discussed about this data types. Data can be of many types, example, character, integer, real, string, etc. Python support following data types: numbers, strings, list, tuple, dictionary. In this number, you can identify the int, float, and complex. Okay. Then, first one, numbers. From the name, it is very clear the number data type are used to store numeric values. Numbers. Numbers in Python can be of following types. First one, integers. Second one, floating point numbers. Third one, complex numbers. In this integers, we can identify the signed integers and booleans also. Okay. Then, integers. Integers allows to store whole numbers only. And there is no fractional parts. Only whole numbers we can store in this integer variable. Okay, integer value means that is a whole number. No fractional parts in that particular integer value. Integers can be positive and negative. You know about this. 100, 250, negative 12, positive 50, etc. There are two integers in Python. That is, first one, integers that is signed. Then second one, booleans. Signed means we can give the sign of that particular integer value. It is normal integer representation of whole numbers. Integers in Python can be on any length. It is only limited by memory available. In Python 3.x, int data type can be used to store big or small integer value, whether it is positive or negative. Positive values and negative integer values we can store in this memory location. Okay, big or small values also we can store in the version of Python 3.x. Clear? Then second one, boolean. It allows to store only two values. Boolean means only two values, that is true and false. The internal value of boolean value true and false is 1 and 0 respectively. That is true, that is equivalent to 1. False, that is equivalent to 0. We can get boolean value from 0 and 1 using which function? Bool function. We can use this bool function for accessing the boolean value. Okay, clear? Then examples, integers. Bool 1, that means that is true. Int false, this false is 0, then we can identify the 0 value. Then str false, here this false is a string value. Str function is used to convert the argument to string type. Str false, so this false considered as a string value. Clear? Next one, floating point numbers. It allows to store numbers with decimal points. Example, 2.14. The decimal point indicates that it is not an integer, but a float value. 100 is an integer, but 100.5 is a float value. In previous chapter, we have already discussed float values that can be of different types, that is fractional form and exponent form. fractional form. You can identify the fractional part also. 200.50, 0.78, negative 12.787. These all are fractional form. Exponent form. It is represented with a mandisa and exponent. Mandisa and exponent. For example, x is equal to 1.5e2. That means 1.5 is the mandisa, then into 10 raised to 2. That is the exponent form, which is 150. 1.5 into 10 raised to 2. That is equivalent to 150. We can represent that is like this format, that is 1.5e2. That is the exponent form. Okay, clear? Print x, that is 150. 150 we will get. Then y is equal to 12.78654e04. Print y, we will get this number. Okay, clear this one? Exponent form. That is in this format, 1.5 into 10 raised to 2. Exponent form of floating point numbers. Okay, clear? Then floating point numbers are mainly used for storing values like distance, area, temperature, etc., which have a fractional part. Floating point numbers have two advantages over integers. It can represent values between the integers. In between 5 and 6, that is 5.1, 5.2, 5.3, etc. These all values we can represent in this floating point numbers. They can represent a much greater range of values. That also possible by using this floating point numbers. But floating point numbers suffers from one disadvantage also. What is its disadvantage? Floating point operations are usually slower than integer operations. Okay. In Python, floating point numbers represent machine level double precision floating point numbers, that is 15 digit precision. In Python, we can identify the 15 digit precision to a floating point number. Okay. Next one, complex numbers. This is the another format of this numbers. Python represent complex numbers in the form of a plus bj. This is the format of a complex number, a plus bj. To represent imaginary numbers, Python uses j or capital J in place of I. In the subject of mathematics, you can identify the complex numbers as a plus ib. Here, real part and imaginary part. But in this concept of Python, we can identify the complex numbers as a plus bj. Here, a is the real part and bj is the imaginary part. Here, imaginary number, that is I or j. Here, this j, small j or capital J, is used to identify the imaginary number. But in this pure mathematics, it identifies the I variable for identifying the imaginary number. Here, this I's value is equivalent to root negative 1. Here we are using this J or capital J for identifying the I value. So, in Python, J is equal to root negative 1. Real part is A, imaginary part is BJ. Both real and imaginary parts are of type float. Okay. You just identify this complex number, that is in the form of A plus BJ. A is the real part and BJ is the imaginary part. Okay. Both real and imaginary parts are of type float. You just identify these all things. Okay. Example, A is equal to 0 plus 6J. B is equal to 2.5 plus 3J. A is equal to 4 plus 5J. Print A. we will get this answer 4 plus 5j. B is equal to 0 plus 2j. Print B, we will get the answer as 2j because here 0 is the real part. So no need to specify the 0 plus. Can identify only imaginary part is there in this B. Okay, clear? Next one, strings. In the previous chapter, we have already discussed about the string. Let us recall the things. First one, string is a collection of any valid characters in a quotation marks. That is single or double. Each character of string in Python is a Unicode character. Strings are used to store information like name, address, descriptions, etc. For example, hello, welcome, sales 2018, python@kvoef.com, anu, these all are examples of this string values. In Python, string is a sequence of characters and each character can be individually accessed using index. What is this index? Here, consider this example. Welcome is the string value. W is stored in this 0th index. E is stored in this 1st index. L is stored in the 2nd index. C is stored in this 3rd index. O is stored in this 4th index. M is stored in this 5th index. E is stored in the 6th index. From the beginning of the first character in string is at index 0. And last will be at len minus 1. Here total 7 characters in this welcome string. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So the first character is in which index? Index 0. Then last character, that is length minus 1. Total 7 characters, 7 minus 1. So 6. Okay. From backward direction, last character will be at index minus 1. And first character will be at minus length or len. From the starting onwards, we are identifying the index, that is forward indexing. From the last onwards, we are identifying the index, that is backward indexing. Always this forward indexing is starting at 0. Always this backward indexing is starting at a negative 1. Okay. So, here we are considering the backward indexing. So, the last character starting at a negative 1 index. Negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, negative 4, negative 5, negative 6 and negative 7. Last character will be at a negative length minus len. Identify this backward indexing and a forward indexing. Always this forward indexing is starting at a 0. Always this backward indexing is starting with a negative 1. Okay, clear? Consider this one. To access individual character of string, that means slicing, we can use the syntax string name then index position. Stream is equal to science. Print stream of 0. 0th index, which is the character? Capital S. So we can identify the S character. Print stream of 3, which is the 3rd index character? 0, 1, 2, 3. That is E, small letter E. So E is the character. Print stream negative 1. That means we are considering here the backward indexing, which is the character at the position negative 1, at index negative 1, that is E. Backward indexing. Always we are using this negative numbers for backward indexing. So starting at the last character, negative 1, which is that character E, small letter E. Then you can see the character E. Okay. Then We cannot change the individual letters of string by assignment because string in Python is immutable. And hence, if we try to do this, Python will raise an error. Object does not support item assignment. We can't change the individual letters of string because in Python the string is immutable. We can't change the individual letters of string. Okay, if you are trying to do that, Python will raise an error. Check this one. Name is equal to Ronaldo. I used here this one, name of one. Name within the square bracket, I specified this one index position. Which is the character? 0, 1, O. O we have to change as I. But here it will raise an error. We can't change individual letters of string because in this Python, the string is immutable. We can't change. So, it will produce an error. However, we can assign a string to another string. We can change the whole string to another one. No error. No problem. Name is equal to Ronaldo. Again, we use this name variable for storing another name. This time, no error. We can assign string to another string. Okay, clear? Okay, children, these all are very easy topics. You just go through this, watch the videos carefully and write down the lecture notes. The notes of the topic is attached. Take down the notes and learn it. A test paper is also included. Submit your answers as soon as possible. That's all for today. We will meet in the next class. Till then, take care.